up and the talk is over. We're set for the big one. Super Bowl 57. Away we go from Arizona. Fielded in the end zone. And we will not have a return. So the first drive of the Super Bowl will begin at the 25. Out comes Washington here offensively. And their man under center, Dwayne Haskins, the number 15 pick out of Ohio State in 2019.
What I enjoyed this week is that you asked to talk to his offensive center before the game and find out a little bit more about him and what the relationship is. And that was a pretty positive story, wasn't it?
Yeah, and really what I took away from that is just how it has permeated throughout the entire offensive line, the relationship they've had. It's really a group that's in sync.
They care about him. That's the thing. They really care. And when you care that much, you're going to play that much harder for him and give him a better chance to lead the team to wins.
As usual, the hallmark of a good run defense, linebackers making plays near the line of scrimmage. Absolutely nowhere to run there.
So after the run for no gain, here's second and 10. From the gun, it's Haskins. He's going to find his running back. It's complete. And from the 25, they work this to the 29, a gain of four. 4 yards the gain, and it'll bring up a third down. Now it's Haskins. And down he goes, but he takes it up to the 40.
For a Washington.
Well, a lot of times when you get a manageable third down situation like this, you have to think about your tight end, and he comes through for him, picking up the first down.
On first down, it's Haskins. That's complete to Moss out of the backfield. And he'll be taken down, but not before he works it past the 50. Same exact result as last play, a pickup of 11. So in Jacksonville territory now, here's a first and 10 at the 49-yard line. Again, it's Haskins. Throwing over the middle, but it's incomplete.
They've given up a few first downs on this drive, but getting the incompletion there, that should give them something to build on and maybe turn the tide.
And the former Heisman winner, this is Mark Ingram. And he's going to get forward for about 5, but that may be coming back. What say you, Mr. Referee? That hold coming from the middle of the line, the center.
And it's difficult for him because sometimes you've got people right over you, and as soon as you snap it, trying to get your hands up and block them, you can be a little bit late getting it done.
And he'll go down shy of the 40 at the 41. They get 14 yards, but not enough for the first down due to the previous penalty. So third and 2, this quite possibly 4 down territory, though, if they're stopped. And this is going to be incomplete.
From the snap, he certainly looked like he knew where he wanted to go with the ball, but surprise, that guy was covered. So that took his attention elsewhere to no avail.
And now the punter, Tress Way, as he sends this one away. Out of bounds as he appeared to be looking for the corner. He got it. They're going to mark this at the 4-yard line. So here are the Jaguars now with a long field ahead. And their quarterback, well, everyone knows he's got height, standing at 6'6".
So this is where we find out about the game plan and the trust factor, don't we? In this situation, the natural thing is take care of the ball, run it inside, everyone cover it. Just, you know, get yourself some room and let your punter punt it out of there. But when you've really got a QB you can trust, you might want to take a little shot early and try and create some space.
Pretty nice work defensively there on the first down run as they hold him to a gain of a couple. Here's a 4-receiver look now. 3 of those guys out to the right side on 2nd and 8.
It's 2nd and 8.
Now they'll throw here out of the gun. And he's going to find his man out of the backfield. That's complete. And able to get it across the 20 before they get to it.
That certainly has to feel good. It's not all the time that the play caller should get all the credit. Sometimes I think in the huddle, the quarterback just says, hey, who's going to make a play for me? I just need something right here. And the end result there, nice first down. Drive keeps moving.
On first down, he'll drop to throw. Quick hitter here, it's complete. Midfield. The catch and run pays off for 29 yards.
Well, I think when they look at their offense, they think to themselves, weapons, weapons everywhere, and they want to move the ball around. They want to spread it to different people. But you absolutely know They want to get this man involved as well, and that's what they just did on that play.
In Washington territory now, here's first and 10 at the 49-yard line. Out of the gun, they'll look to throw. As he throws there, incomplete.
Pressure, and that's certainly going to be a key to this game going forward. And that time, they were able to get in there and influence the throw. And remember, quarterbacks got to get rid of it. They don't have the Tucker roll that they can fall back on anymore.
Man over the middle, and it's complete. So apparently some grabbing there in the middle of the O-line.
I've often wondered why that doesn't happen more often for guys that play center. Having to snap the ball and then trying to get your hands into the proper position, that's difficult to do. He got caught that time.
There's a ball thrown right side and complete. And they're going to have another first down here as the tackle's made at Washington's 9-yard line. 35, 23 yards the pickup there.
I don't care who you put on him, he's going to be a handful in one-on-one throws.
Yeah, right now, you're right. They're in man-to-man, maybe need some safety help.
I would say that'd be a good idea. Double-team him somehow. I'm going to have to make someone else beat me rather than let him shred my defense.
Ball up to the 35 now as they come up on first and 10. They'll stick with the passing game as he looks to throw. And a quick throw here, that's complete. And he's got this down almost to the 20 before he's dropped. Back-to-back nice gains, that one for 14 yards and another first.
First and 10 at the 21-yard line.
Back to throw again. This is caught, and he takes it in. Touchdown, Jacksonville, with the first touchdown of this Super Bowl. And the Jags have taken the early lead. One of the keys to their long winning streak has been scoring first. An ideal drive right there, getting the first 6 points of the ball game.
Do you go back to our meeting with the offensive coordinator?
Remember what
he told us?
Absolutely.
With some teams, I script to probe in the early part of the game. Other teams, I script to attack. They've been in attack mode for these ball games and continue that in this one.
Point after by Lambeau, up and good. And it's now a 7-0 game. Touchdown. He'll kick this one away. Taken in the end zone. And it'll come out to the 25 as he will not attempt to return.
25-yard.
Now Washington going to retake the field for drive number two. They trail early on in this Super Bowl as they come up first and 10. Him with two to go on second down.
The tackle made by Miles Jack. 8 yards on the pickup. Brings up second and two at the 33-yard line.
After one, 7-0 on EA Sports.
The score, Jaguars 7, Washington nothing.
Here's a second and two now from the 33. They run with Edwards, and he'll be taken down right around the 34 after a pickup of only a yard.
Some of these play calls, I think they're a little conservative, but you know me, because it's easy to sit up in this booth, right, and make all the calls and think I'm going to be correct. But I would like to see them open things up, because otherwise this defense just can gang up on the run and set them down.
Washington. First and 10 at the 40-yard line.
Haskins looking to throw on first down. That's complete. Terry McLaurin with it. And he'll be brought down just shy of midfield at the 49-yard line. A good pickup there. 8 yards on the first down completion. Facing a second and two after that last catch. Good for 8 yards. Here's Haskins to throw. It's a short one here. Complete to the tight end. And he'll get it down to the 46. 7 here. His second catch of the Super Bowl, and it's good enough for a first down. Stepping up, he's going to keep it. Give him 4 yards there on the first down keeper.
Brandon, we just saw the benefits of being able to run the ball successfully. They pick up 4 yards on that carry. So now if you're a play caller, you can do just about anything you want. But on the defensive side of the ball, you scramble a little bit. Now you're behind trying to figure out, do I need to blitz him? Do I need to pressure him? How do I gain an advantage on this step?
His second catch of the Super Bowl, and it's good enough for a first down.
Now that was pretty. They executed that curl route versus zone coverage, and that changes things a little bit because against man, it's often a tight curl, a tight, sharply run route. Against zone, you're just looking for that open spot, that dead area, so you may curl a little bit wider just to get to that place.
And usually a tight window. He fired a bullet in there for the completion. Play fake here on first down. That is caught right at the 10-yard line. And he gets it all the way down inside the 10 and mark him at the 5.
First down. First and goal at the 5-yard line.
Plays in succession. Not sure this D knows what hit him, but now they got to get ready. It's first and goal. They'll run here with Edwards. And he takes it in. Touchdown, Washington. A 5-yard touchdown run. And Washington now an extra point away from tying this thing up. That almost looked too easy, and I think thanks goes to the offensive line for making it look easy.
Yeah, I agree with you totally on that one. I'm not sure how much everyone understands the preparations that go into a game for an offensive line, because there's a reason that running backs and quarterbacks give them big gifts at the end of the season after a big year. The consistency and the continuity it takes to know each other and execute their blocks is pretty impressive.
It's up and good, and we're tied at 7 here in quarter number 2. So that drive consumes 9 plays all told, and it's finished off with a 5-yard touchdown run. So all even at 7 now as they kick it away. Fielded a couple yards into the end zone. Get him down right at the 25-yard line, so the same result, and he opted for the touchback.
25-yard line.
Jaguars come to the line to start their next drive. And they had to wait a long time to get the football back. Probably not what you were hoping for when you got an offensive tumble.
Agreed. What you were looking for is the defense get the ball back pretty quickly, right? Hoping for a 3-and-out. So that didn't happen. You can't yell at your D for that. They've got to take care of their own business and reestablish themselves now that they're back on the field. They'd love to just strike back with a touchdown right here. And if it's a long play, so be it. But the main goal, get a couple of first downs, run some plays, run some clock, allow their defense to get a chance to catch their breath, settle down, and relax a little bit after they just gave up the score.
2 minutes on the clock in the second quarter of this Super Bowl. Coming up in a couple of minutes, we'll get you to Jonathan Coachman in Orlando. The coach will have stats and scores from earlier today in the NFL. And a man open down the middle of the field. That one, a first down pickup of 8.
Fired that one in there, able to make connection on a nice in route.
With those faster passes when they're going that fast, any hesitation as a quarterback that the deflection, if you miss, might be bigger and lead to an interception?
Yeah, and the deflection works both ways. Maybe a defender gets a hand in the way and it pops. pops in the air. And sometimes you throw it so hard your receiver can't handle it, and he pumps it up in the air for the defenders to grab as well.
But a moot point there as they were able to connect. Had it. The big D lineman nearly had an interception. Instead, it falls down incomplete.
Brings up third down and two.
They'll go to the air here on third and two. Got a man, and he hits him in stride. And we'll get this in the end zone for a Jaguar touchdown. Jaguars have taken the lead. Well, that's a heck of a response to regain the lead after we had seen the touchdown to tie the game.
I would say what we just saw there was a great amount of poise, because typically when teams tie the game up, it's a little bit of a, how would you say, you kind of take a step back and have to get yourself regrouped. They regrouped in a hurry, didn't they? They attacked back after they'd been tied.
And in a big way, that was a statement long touchdown. One extra point tacked on by Lambeau, and that makes the score 14-7.
Josh Lambeau to kick off for Jacksonville.
And Lambeau now, after the touchdown, he'll kick this one away. And this will make it into the end zone, and this will not be brought out. It's a touchback.
Their own 25-yard line.
Washington ready to try again on offense. It was still more than a minute to go in the half. Time to try to mount a drive.
And I would think that they would have to. This is today's NFL. You got to push it whenever you get an opportunity. You could never have enough points with the high-powered offenses that you face. And analytics will tell you, try and score when given the opportunity.
Well, throw left side to start out. That's complete. And he's brought down, getting this one up to about the 35. Washington now going to use the first of their three timeouts, as he'll stop it with exactly a minute to go before halftime. Ball up to the 35 now as they come up on first and 10. Out of the shotgun, Haskins looking left side, and he's got a man. That's Ingram. Now Washington going to use the second of their three timeouts, as the clock will stop with 55 seconds to go until halftime. Throwing again on second down, Haskins. And the Jags get to him as down he goes. Yannick Ngakoue. Credit him with a sack as he buries him for a loss of 10. Throwing the out route incomplete. It's Tate. And he can only manage to take the football to the 40, and that is well shy of the first down marker.
Fourth down.
Here's Tressway now, as he'll kick it away for the second time. It'll be down at the 14-yard line.
That's the end of the
so it's halftime here on sports' grandest stage in the Super Bowl. As we send you on out to our studios in Orlando, here's Jonathan Coachman at REA Sports Halftime Report.
Okay, Brandon, thanks very much. What a season this has been. Hard to believe it ends tonight, as we'll get back to you guys for the second half of this Super Bowl in just a moment. It's been a tremendous season of football, but it's not over yet. One half remains to decide who will stand on the podium with the Vince Lombardi Trophy. And to call the second half, here are Brandon Godden and Charles Davis.
Okay, Coach, appreciate it. A one-touchdown game here as we get set to resume play in the second half. And he's up across the 25 and down at the 28.
First and 10 at their own 28-yard line.
Out come the Jaguars now as they'll go on offense first here in this third quarter. And right now they're saying, hey, let's keep this going. Two drives, two touchdowns.
Yeah, can't ask for a better start than that, can you? I mean, this is the way you practice it. This is the way you rehearse it. But right now, the play calling, they're locked in really well.
After a pickup of 8, second and 2.
But a lot of times, these plays, they either go for nothing or they go for big yardage. And here, they got to the outside, turned it upfield, and ended up getting a nice little gain out of it.
From the shotgun now, here's an inside give. He'll be taken down, but not before he works it past the 50.
Good, tough running right up the middle. And if the defense can't penetrate and make him slow his pace or change direction, that's often the end result.
Back-to-back good plays have him on the move on first down. They run the option here on first and 10. And he's corralled, but not before getting it inside the 35. A good gain again. That's now 31 yards combined on those last two plays.
Well, you certainly have to give a little credit here because they're playing this game now at their pace. This is ball control football, sustained runs, taking their time, and making it work.
So they'll come up first and 10 now from the 33. From the shotgun now, here's an inside give. And boy, showing how tough he can be to bring down, just fighting his way forward to pick up 7 yards. A good run, got 7 on first, here's second and 3. Here's a throw that's taken in out of the backfield. And he'll take it down here just shy of the 15 at the 16-yard line. So the ball down to the 16 here for first and 10. From the shotgun now, here's an inside give. And he's brought down just outside of the 10 at the 11. Colton Hill, the one there to bring him down.
It's a gain of 5. Brings up second.
Second and 5. Flush draws right. And now he's going to use his legs. And the Jags are going to be set up with a first and goal coming up as they get him down at the 6-yard line. 5 yards on the scramble, and that's enough to pick up the first. They scored touchdowns on drives 1 and 2, and now they're trying to make it a perfect 3-for-3 to start. From the shotgun now, here's an inside give. And a minuscule gain of maybe 1 yard from the 6 to the 5. Only 1 yard on the pickup there. Second and goal.
Brings up second and goal at the 5-yard line.
And he takes it in. Touchdown, Jacksonville. A 5-yard touchdown. And the Jaguars add 6 to their lead. Circle that drive because that might be one to remember. Well executed to give them a little cushion.
Well, let's take it into the boxing ring. You talk about them commanding it, keeping the fight where they wanted to, whether it was in the center of the ring or putting them on the ropes, because it was jab, jab, jab. And finally, the haymaker to put that drive away.
It's good, and it is now 21-7. That time, a 9-play drive, and it results in a touchdown for Jacksonville.
Washington, 7. Josh Lambeau to kick off for Jacksonville.
And Lambeau now, after the touchdown, he'll kick this one away. Fielded in the end zone. And no effort to bring this one out. It's a touchback.
At their own 25-yard line.
First possession of the second half now for Washington. And down on the scoreboard, certainly needing to avoid what happened on the last drive, punting the football.
Sense of urgency has to take over for them here. They know the score. They know the situation. And by the way, the punter no longer exists for their offense. That's how they have to treat this drive.
They need points.
Big time.
Got an open man, it's Harmon.
Well, it's time for them to be good teammates right here. And what I mean by that is possess the ball for a little while. Get at least two first downs. Give their defense a chance to settle down a little bit after they give up a touchdown.
And he'll be brought down right around the 37. A gain of 5, good enough for the first down.
First and 10 at the 37-yard line.
Stepping up, he'll try and run. And down he goes at the 45 after a pickup of 9. And after getting tackled, he's still down and looking very slow to get up. While the training staff takes a peek, we'll take a break. Second down, here's a keeper by the QB. And taking it across midfield and inside the 45. 11 yards there, first down. Okay, take us to school here, Charles. On a play like that, pretty successful RPO, what's the quarterback looking at?
Basics, he's looking at the defensive end or the outside linebacker. If that player crashes down to take the running back, quarterback pulls it, runs to the outside end. Some teams, though, will read different players depending on defenses, but basically, it's that outside player.
So in Jacksonville territory now, here's a first and 10 at the 44-yard line. Under pressure, and he will go down. Sacked back at the 46. Yannick Ngakoue able to drop him that time for his second sack of the evening. Super Bowl. This is the National Football League on EA Sports. And the job becomes twice as difficult now after the sack. It's second and 20. Here's Haskins out of the gun. That's complete to his receiver McLaurin. And they'll get this just to the 47. 1 yard gain. That catch good for only a yard, and it'll be third down. Operating from the gun, Haskins, and that will be incomplete.
It's been clear in this matchup which side has been the more physical one. It's been this defense. And here's another example on that last play.
They'll try and throw for it with Haskins. Catch is made. It's Harmon. And unable to break away. They stop him a few yards shy. Washington goes for it, but it does not pan out. And it'll be a turnover on downs. So they really needed points here in a two-score game. Could not come away with anything there on fourth.
And while we know they're a little bit discouraged here, they can't check out of this game. You and I have called a good number of games over the course of our career where we've seen these types of situations. Teams get the ball back, and that miracle does occur. So they can't let that dream go just yet. They have to get stout on defense here.
Yeah, right now, really hoping for a turnover. They'll come out throwing here to start the drive. Looking left side, and it's complete. Touchdown of this Super Bowl. And the Jaguars add on to their lead. They had the lead in the fourth, but still passing. Finding the big target for the touchdown. Now that lead grows even more.
Everybody gets to join in the fun. You know, it doesn't have to just be the wide receivers catching touchdown passes. The tight end doesn't just have to do just the dirty work inside. He gets a chance to get into the end zone as well.
Lambeau to add on the extra point. He knocks it through. It's 28-7. Those are the kind of drives they like on offense, from the coordinator to the quarterback, the line, everybody. One play drive and into the end zone for six. after the touchdown. He'll kick this one away. Taken in the end zone. And this will not be returned. It'll come out to the 25.
At their own 25-yard line.
So look at Washington as they come onto the field. And it's becoming more and more apparent that this is just not going to be their night. That Lombardi Trophy so close, but the expectations simply have not matched the results as they start on this drive, first and 10. Haskins and the Washington offense going to come up here first and 10 at their own 25-yard line. From the gun, Haskins firing quickly here, and that's complete. This will be stopped about 2 yards shy of the marker. 8 yard gain, second and 2.
I know many people like to throw to the tight end, maybe in a little flexed out position because he creates mismatches with his size. But slot receivers do the same thing with their quickness, their speed, and their route running savvy.
Now this one over the middle, into the hands of this tight end, complete. And to the 42 yard line here and brought down there. Back to back good plays have him on the move on first down. Operating from the gun, Haskins. And he's got his man out of the backfield. That's complete. And the result here, a pickup of 8. Leaves him with 2 to go on second down.
On the pickup, brings up 2nd and 2 at the 50-yard line.
From midfield now, Haskins. Quick hitter here, it's complete. And he'll get it down to the 47 here.
Washington. First and 10 at the 47-yard line.
Now Haskins on first down. And quick throw here, that's complete. And he is tackled inside the 40, not quite to the 35. It's a first down for Washington on a pickup of 11. Throwing now, Haskins on first down. That one is slant to McClure. And they are able to stop it, but he does take it all the way to the 2. It's a gain of 34. Now defensively, I know they have the comfortable lead here in the 4th, but they do not want to give up big plays like that.
They want to finish strong. So oftentimes in this situation, you tighten up underneath in your coverage, and you bring your safeties back. They can pick up anything that leaks through. But in the meantime, upfield, you're making plays on the football.
Haskins going to throw again. To the goal line, but it's incomplete.
That was a touchdown if he could have hung on. Instead, it was a well-timed collision to jar that one free.
Second and goal, and they will try again from the 2-yard line. Throwing again, here's Haskins. Dropped. Back at the 15-yard line. Josh Allen. What a play by him. That's going to go as a loss of 13. Looking in zone, but it's incomplete. Well, it just seems like all game long, there hasn't been a lot of sync quarterback to wide receiver on this side of the football.
They haven't been on the same page, quarterback and receivers. Heck, they haven't been on the same grease board when you draw plays up. They haven't been on the same surface tablet that you look at on the sidelines. Nothing's worked for them. They've got to find a way to start matching each other's movements.
They can't hook up here on the 4th down pass attempt, and that may write a finish to this Super Bowl. Jacksonville back on offense and ready to take over. And they are trying to play it cool down on the sidelines, but they know that they are very close now to wrapping this thing up and letting the celebration begin. A Super Bowl title within reach now as they try to polish this thing off. They'll try and run some clock here as they keep it on the ground. And not much there at all. He's up only to about the 16-yard line.
That's it. That's what you want. Straight ahead, positive gain. Just keep that clock ticking.
Here's 2nd and 9, just a yard on that last run. Now a handoff looking right. And he'll be taken down, but not before he gets this football out shy of the 30 to the 29. A Gain of 13. It's a first down.
I'm not sure how much more evidence they need, partner, than to understand that if they don't start to slow him down, it's going to be a long afternoon here at the stadium, because he is just shredding them at this point. And let's face it, coming into the game, they knew he would be the focal point of their attack. This is going to take an 11-man unit on the defensive side to start making plays.
Going to give this time to the tailback. Take this up just shy of the 40. Excellent display of footwork on that run. And now we'll get a timeout. Looks like we've got a Jaguar in some discomfort down there on the field. We'll check on his status when we get back. Yards the gain on that last run. Here's second and a couple. And now Chenault on the end around. And this winds up a pickup of two, maybe two and a half, to about the 39.
He's brought down.
Defensively, they had that one pretty well figured out.
Yeah, one of the things about this play, it can be even more effective when you run a lot of motion and there's plenty of times you don't hand it off.
Complete with a clock down now to 13 seconds.
The contact. It's now fourth down.
And the Jaguars send out their punter. Always a good sign when your first punt comes in the fourth quarter. That'll go as a punt of 34 yards that time. And there'll be time for maybe one final play before we hit triple zeros.
Out there, set and ready for this next drive, the Washington offense.
This is just an exercise in futility. Do you even bother running a play here offensively?
I wouldn't, because now is not going to erase.
He's got a man complete. And he's taken down right at the 45-yard line. And the Jaguars have done it. Jacksonville, the Super Bowl champions. For the victors getting to hoist that Lombardi trophy, you know, we've talked to guys that have done it, and they say there's no better feeling in sports.
I don't know how there can be. The journey to get to this game is incredible. And then to finally break through and win it when all eyes are on this game alone because there's nothing else going on, that's just got to be absolutely amazing. That, the task, incredible. The accomplishment, forever.
Champs, the Lombardi Trophy is theirs, and so are bragging rights for an entire season. What a season it has been. Feels like we have been there every step of the way. Our entire crew doing a wonderful job. Thanks to my broadcast partner, Charles Davis. For all those guys, I'm Brandon Gunn signing off. We'll talk to you next season right here on EA Sports.
Someone put me out cause I'm on fire. I can't give a fuck about what they say. They've been searching for that thing to get them higher. You can't catch my drift, can't catch my wave.
Damn, Kane, you done kill Abel. Unbalanced land, trying to keep the people stable. The way I feel, I might f*** it all up. The way you feel, you might do it for the buck. All black,
Born to be a rebel. After this, I might go and water down the devil. Listen to everything around me. I can't see. You picked a dozen roses and left them in Galilee rolling thunder. Don't hear my cry. Don't let alibis pass you. I finally starting to realize. Never give up and coerce. I can't watch TV. It's all a lot. Tired of trying. Go ahead and fly. Everybody want a straight answer. But media keep us blind. A good heart is not hard to find. Why do people try to define infrastructure? Right? I don't got time. Infrastructure, right? I don't got time. It's all too. We're talking about your brother protecting themselves and daughters from political slaughter.
Someone put me out cause I'm on fire. I can't give up about what they say. They've been searching for that thing to get them higher.
This is the last opportunity to re-sign your players or they'll become free agents.
Play by the rules, that's I'm paying my dues. They gon' try to intrude, poison the multitude. They be quick to accuse, when you got different views. Just know you gon' pay the price, best up the item you choose. Many ties in the culture, hit you with them K-Ultra. I knew you was a vulture, Holy Ghost get the ushers. No, I can't trust you, shock you, deny you fluster. Crashing down, I was cluttered, doing this so subtle. Fumbling out through the rubble, remember this in jungle. The top, I was gonna get something. The middle, gotta stay hunting. Why the rush up for nothing? 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 Agitated illusion, only built for confusion. The institution, my the execution, think I knew the solution. Maybe not should I do it, just put it in the music. Just put it in the music.
Someone put me out cause I'm on fire. I can't give up about what they say. They've been searching for that thing to get them higher. You can't catch my drift, can't catch my wave.